I'm hoping to have the first stuff up by the end of this week.
Nice.
Actually, I'm not hoping. I will. At the end of the day, you know, like that's the thing about me, though. I'm a huge perfectionist. I got to get everything ready. I got to get all things aligned. I think my son gets a lot of that from me. And so everything's got to be like perfectly set up. And, but I have to learn this software. And, I have to learn this equipment to make this better. And then I'm recognizing just put out your first video. It's not going to be the best video. It's not. It's because it's the first. And so just put it out there and then keep putting it out there. And then you're going to get with time that experience to know what to do and how to do and where to do. But I hope I'm going to reach an audience or at least make an impression on my first one or on my 100th one. It doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. But really just start putting it out there and just showing the world what I know and mm-hmm. doing it in a way that it's like entertaining, but also informative, you know, mm-hmm. for someone that's watching and really gets it and really feels like they're being personally spoken to about what's happening for them or something that they're passionate about. That's why they found the video, and to find different ways of looking at it or ways to use it or, you know, further steps to be more involved in it.
Mm-hmm.
So like, that's kind of what I'm excited about. I got a few thoughts floating around my head, and I think a lot of it is originally going to be, or initially going to be, very much things, lifestyle things that, or medical aspects of our life that we could all recognize and resonate with. Mm-hmm. So this is not so much a channel for my colleagues. This is not something that, like, I wouldn't be watching my colleagues' channel if they were talking about stuff that I do already. But sometimes it's nice to hear a different person's take on it. Mm-hmm. And the analogies is what I'm always most interested in, is because analogies is a different way to tell a story. Mm-hmm. But the story has the same impact or the same outcome. And so I think this is more so for the public that I'm doing this. And mm-hmm. who knows, you know, unfold organically, and I get to see who my community is. And I wouldn't be surprised if, you know, it's sort of like show me your friends and I'll show you who you are, that your community ends up being a bit of a reflection of yourself, right? Because that's what people can connect with.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true. That's a good point. Actually, I never really thought about that they would kind of be like you.
Yeah. I mean, there's got to be some sort of overlapping interest, I imagine.
Yeah, yeah.
It's humor, or it's in the delivery, or it's in, you know, the joy you have in, I don't know, putting drones on the chap, or who knows what.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, yeah. No, that'll be good, though, to get to, yeah. I mean, and I think that's huge, too, just starting and getting something out there. I think, like, even you and I, like, even now that you just say that, like, you know, you kind of attract people like yourself. I'm literally the exact same way. It's like so perfectionist with the podcast, like even this, when my first time, like, took me a year to do it.
Yeah,
because I was like, nope, it's not ready yet. I don't know enough. It's not going to be.
And the fear of failure, right?
Yeah.
That's a big one. The fear of failure, the fear of not being good enough. And like, that's why, you know, I easily preach to people, oh, you know, like, this is a time where you need to slow down and you need to become a creator. Well, not need to, you know, if you have, I think we all have the ability to create within us. So yeah, I think in some degree you should be able to do that. But the problem with creating is that it creates an opportunity for failure,
mm-hmm.
or rejection, for commentary, or not good enough. And I think when you get over that hump, you realize, it's not so bad.
No. Like, and like,
those things are going to take place anyways.
Yeah. And like, if you're the one putting yourself out there, and people are commenting or whatever, maybe saying they don't, you know, I think people are always scared of negative comments or feedback, but at the end of the day, like, the people who are giving you that are people who are, they're too scared to do what you're doing anyways.
No, you're so right about that.
Like, if you're the one who's in the ring playing the game and they're not, then it doesn't really matter what they say. What kind of, like, they don't really have any advice.
Yeah, I think that's where also I come against a little bit of my own obstructions, because, you know, I've looked at other people doing social media and, you know, walking around with their cameras and talking about stuff. And there's many times topics I am not interested in, and judge it.
Mm-hmm.
Judge it. I'm very much a lurker in the way that I don't really write anything, but I
do
my own opinions like everyone does. And I think to myself, oh my God, I could never do that. Who wants to know that? Oh, that's terrible, whatnot. And then when I started wanting to think about doing this, I really came against myself and I realized, you know, whatever these people are talking about, even if I don't resonate it, they're showing up.
Mm-hmm.
They're actually showing up. And they're showing up authentically in the way that they know, or even if it's inauthentic and they're just getting something else out of it, they're at least doing it. Mm-hmm. That's That's got to be celebrated, you know? So, and I guess that's what I'm kind of like hesitating to, right? So, like I said, this week for sure, it's going down. It's happening.
We'll have a big celebration for your first
big celebratory. I'm going to send you the video. You know, you know what? You should be critiquing all of it so I can get over my health easier.
How long were you going to do the videos? Are they going to be like longer or shorter?
No, 10, 15 minutes. I think anything over than that is killing people's time. I really respect people's time, and I want to make sure they get what they want out of it and that they get to learn something, but also feel entertained. Not just that, you know, you went through like a Wikipedia page and you just learned a bunch of stuff. Mm-hmm. And I definitely didn't want to, and I wanted to create, you know, different footage, different areas, different scenarios. Maybe I'll dress up even at times differently. And just to like keep a person engaged in this, because, you know, I was in a teaching role for quite some time. I was a supervisor with students, and I recognize like people don't have an attention span for like an hour. That's sometimes what I struggle with, is when I go on YouTube and I see colleagues of mine do a presentation. Well, certainly they actually just filmed their presentation that was meant for an audience, not for an online audience. But they filmed that, and I'm just like, oh, I'm sitting here, it's pixelated, the audio's terrible, and it's an hour of just talking. And unless you're just like, you know, unless that's your like lifeblood and you just love that topic, it's kind of difficult to stay the whole way there for it. So I think I want to create something that's really informative and applicable for yourself in a very health-related capacity, which a lot of things are.